Welcome to the deck video for the Chief Architect Bachelor View project. In this video, I'll cover building a deck with the railing tool, framing the deck using the automatic and manual tools, and then build the custom columns and look at generating a materials list. Let's place a deck on the back side of the house. You can see in my split screen view, my floor plan is where I'm actually going to draw the deck walls. I have my 3D view up on the right hand side of the screen, and you'll be able to see the progress as we draw the walls. Over in my floor plan view, I'm going to come over and I'm going to choose the straight deck railing tool. As I do this, you'll be able to see the results over in the 3D view. So right now, I'm merely working on the specific shape of the deck, and then when I'm finished, I'll go ahead and add my dimensions. Now you're going to notice once I finished with that last wall and enclosed the deck room, it automatically created the deck complete with all of the framing components. If you click inside of this room, I'll just go ahead and double click right in this 3D view. Since I used the deck railing, it came in with the room type of deck, and you can come over to the deck panel inside of this room specification, and you'll see the different options available to the deck itself. One of them is to automatically regenerate the deck framing. Over here underneath the deck, you'll find joists, the posts, and the footings. They go down to meet the floor below. And then you're going to find the options for the deck planking, the width, the gap, the border against walls if you want it, or a herringbone pattern, the deck joist information, and then there's another panel for the deck support where you can come in and specify the beam information. You can click on the edit button. You can see the defaults that I'm using for this deck, and you're going to find the same types of settings for the post footing. So on the deck and the deck structure panel, you'll find a lot of information available. I've also changed my decking materials, in this case to use a Trex or a composite material. When I build the deck, it automatically will use those default settings that I've specified for my deck room. Now I'm going to go back into the floor plan view, and I want to dimension this deck that I've added on here, and I'm going to use the manual dimension tool. I'm going to come over here and create my dimensions. I'm just going to click and drag along the outside of the wall and go ahead and place these dimensions just on the outside of the wall, and then we'll use those dimensions to then shape the deck. Let's zoom in and just make sure that this deck is connecting into what we call the main layer in Chief Architect, so that actually goes to the stud layer, not to the outside of the siding. And now I'm just going to work my way around and size this deck. I'll mouse over the dimension. I'm going to set this length to be 14 feet. On this wall over here, I'll go ahead and set that to be 25 foot 7 inches. And then on this wall, we'll go ahead and set that to be 5 foot 3. And then really the final dimension over here, I'll go ahead and set that to be 32 feet. Maybe clean up these dimensions a little bit, kind of move them in and make adjustments to them. Now that I have this sized, I want to make some adjustments in the 3D view. Let's go back over. I'm going to take these outer rim boards and I want to change them to be much larger. I'm just going to hold the shift key down, shift select on them, rotate around here just a little bit. Now I'm just holding down the shift key while I do that. While I'm orbiting around, I'm holding down the alt key, so I'm still in a selection mode. And then the final rim board, I'll go ahead and grab that, come down, click the open button in the lower left-hand corner of your screen. And as I make an adjustment in here, I'm going to make sure that the lock top height is marked. And then for the depth, I'm going to come down here and I'm going to use an engineered piece of wood and I'm going to set it to be 21 inches. And then I'm going to come over to the materials. I often do this in 3D, but since I have several of them selected, it's just easy to come over to the materials. I'm going to come over, select a plan material for those rim joists. And I've been using an existing color down here. I'm just going to come down and find that particular color. See the paint code. Now you're going to notice as I went to close this dialog, there is a message that says that my automatic deck framing is on and will be turned off since I have modified those rim joists. And I'm okay with that. Notice that I did my dimensioning before I made any of the changes, because the automatic deck framing is a very beneficial feature and I would like to take advantage of that, but I don't want to do it until the very end when I'm ready to do customizations to the deck. So I'm going to go ahead and turn off the automatic framing. Now you may have noticed earlier in my video that I used the reference display option. And if I use that reference display, I can turn that on and display the deck framing below. If you want to learn more about the reference display feature, you can look that up. If you click on the floor indicator, you can use a reference display, and I built a layer set for referencing the deck and just turned on those layers that I want to superimpose from the floor below. And you'll notice that in this case it's my beams and my joists for the deck as well as the posts. Let's go ahead and go down the floor below, and I'm going to turn off that reference display. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the majority of these posts. So I'm going to hold my shift key down. I'm going to draw a marquee around these posts. And I'm going to leave this one in the far left corner because I want to use that as the basis for the column. So again, I'm going to continue holding my shift key down, draw that around those particular posts. And then when I'm finished with this last one over here, I'm just going to simply press the delete key. Now for this post in the corner, I'm going to use this to create the column. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and click on this footing. I'm going to press the C on my keyboard for concentric. And I'm just going to simply make this much larger temporarily until I make the adjustment to the post, and then we'll come back and size that accordingly. I'm going to go ahead and select the post, double click and open it up. And I'm going to size this post. Again, this is going to be actually a column, but I'm using this as my basis for the column. I'm going to make it 36 inches square, and then I'm going to also subtract the overall height, begin by locking the bottom, and I'm just going to subtract 6 inches from the overall height to make the adjustment for that column. With that change, I'll go ahead and select the footing, and I'm going to pull that back in using the C for concentric resize on the keyboard, and now you can see how that has been adjusted. Now the next thing I'm going to do is create the top plate for that column. If you look at it in 3D so far, you'll see one gigantic column. In fact, let's just use our material eyedropper. We'll pick up the stone off of the house and apply it onto the column. And what I want to do now is I want to create the cap for the column. In the plan view, I'm going to use a polyline solid tool. I'm going to come over and draw this right on top of the cap, maybe extend it just a little bit once I've got it drawn, use the C on the keyboard so it's a little bit larger than the column itself. And let's go ahead and open this up by double clicking on it. I'm going to set the thickness of it to be 6 inches. And then as far as the floor to bottom goes, let's go ahead and make an adjustment in here. And I'm going to set it to be 109, and I'm probably going to have to take a look at this in 3D and make an adjustment there. Let's return back to the 3D view, and maybe I'll adjust the view a little bit so we can see what we have. Let's go ahead and toggle on our vector view. It'd be a lot more accurate to do this in an elevation view, but I'm just going to pull that down and snap it right on top, and I think that looks pretty good. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create 3 more copies of this and place them down the side of the deck for the support. Let's go back into our floor plan view. We'll zoom out a little bit. And here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to hold my shift key down, click and drag to create a marquee around the footing, the cap, and the post. In the lower edit menu, I'm going to use the copy button, and then I'm going to go into a sticky mode that will allow me to repeat that copy. Let's go ahead and slide a copy of this, and maybe I'll toggle on my crosshair so that I can line it up with the wall above so you can see that it's lined up with my crosshairs. We'll go ahead and slide another one, and sometimes when you're moving something, notice that it's bumping right here. I can actually hold down my control key and override the bumping and snapping inside of the program. Go ahead and release, and then slide one more copy down the edge, and again, just using the crosshairs that I toggled on, using the hotkey to toggle the crosshair on. And now when we go back into the 3D view, you can see the different columns that we've added for the support. Now, a couple final things that I'm going to do for the deck. Let's go ahead and I want to put an opening in the deck railing right here, and then go into the library and place a set of spiral stairs. To put a hole in the railing, I'm just going to use a doorway. I'm going to come over here, click the doorway inside of the deck, and then open up the library, I'm going to find the spiral stairs. Now I happen to have one already set aside. You can always use the search key and find these objects. Let's go ahead and place this. It's probably going to be easier to do this in the floor plan view, so we can be a little more precise. Let's slide over here, and I'm just going to come over here and click and place those spiral stairs. Let's rotate it so that the opening is facing the deck, and then we'll just go ahead and slide it right in there. And if you look at it in 3D, you can see exactly where we have that spiral stairs placed. And then I'll do the same thing over on the other side. We'll just use the doorway tool and click and place a doorway right onto the deck opening. And then it's easiest just to kind of bump and slide that against where you need it to be. And then I'm going to have a walkway when we do our terrain. So that pretty much covers the step for most of the creation of the decks. If you're looking to run a materials list for the deck, you can click inside the room. There is a tool specifically for decks. It's called the Calculate Structural Materials for the Deck. And let's go ahead and run that here real quickly. This spreadsheet-like materials list will open. You can see all of the components that make up your deck. You'll notice that down in this area right here, we have treated posts that are 36 inches. You can always select this item. Let's go ahead and find this in the plan. Notice that it automatically jumps you right into the plan. From here, you actually could open these up. And on the component information, if you wanted to remove those out of the materials list, you could either click on this deck and walks, move it into maybe masonry, and then in the accounting code, you could make the same change. And then that will update your materials list so that those will not be included for the framing components for your deck. Well, that concludes this deck video for the Bachelor View project. In the next segment, I'm going to create a terrain and site plan.